There we go. Well, good morning, everybody. Driving over here, Kevin was like, James, you know, just be ready. There's going to be about 10 people here because it's raining. You guys so surprised me. I kept seeing you come up, and I'm like, oh, my God. Where's Cal? Cal in Virginia. You know, they watch all the time, but they don't come that often. I was like, so it's a rainstorm, and you thought today's a good day to go out. So anyway, welcome. And welcome to all of the rest of you that stayed at home with your French toast and your pajamas. We are here to inspire you today. Is there anybody here? I know there is, actually. For the first time today. If you're here for the first time, stand up. Go ahead and stand up. This is William. Say good morning to William. Hey, William, tell me what you do. That's you, William. Oh, I mean just in life.
Well, currently I'm out of work for mental health issues, and I'm attending a day treatment program.
With Audrey Larson. Yes. So I just want to tell you, you are so welcome here, and we are so, he watched us on video. And then came today. I think Audrey invited him. Yes. So we're going to sing this first song for you so you can stay standing. Go ahead, everybody rise. All rise. Here we go.
I can't help it. God makes me want to sing. I can't help it. It makes me feel so good, I can do most anything.
Well, I am loving every living thing.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I can see the face of God in paupers and kings.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Well, we're all precious, no one less or more. We all got the same treasure in store. I am loving.
Guiding light,
right, Tiffany?
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
You know what, Doug? Whatever happens, it always turns out right.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I just dig right down to how I feel. I take a deep breath and I grab that wheel. I'm believing in my guiding light. Here we go, everybody, come on.
I can't help it. God makes me want to sing. Oh,
my highest place, with the wind at my back and a smile on my face. Well, I'm living my dream more and more each day. I just don't care what those wiggles say. I am reaching for my highest place. Okay, let me hear you now. Come on, Glenda.
I can't help it. God makes me want to sing. I can't help it.
Come on, Carson.
God makes me want to sing. It makes me feel so good. I can do most anything.
How's it make you feel, lady?
It makes me feel so good. I can do most anything.
How about you, Diane Blayman?
It makes me feel so good. I can do. do most anything.
Wow, how's that feel? You got so quiet so fast. Trying to recover? Well, I feel great. How do y'all feel? Great. Really? I'll try that again. I feel great. How do you all feel?
Great.
There you go. Okay, so we come here every Sunday as a spiritual community to do what, Dr. Eric?
So many things.
Pick one.
To love only.
Oh, okay, we can go there. To love only. What else, Dr. Tiffany? Did you like that? Did you hear her? To stay tethered to the truth of who she is. And who are you? You are God. She's so good. She totally gets it. Okay. Jim, what are you doing here?
Looking at you.
Then you're having a lovely experience. What?
Remembering who I am.
Okay, good. So you all skipped right over forgive everything. Is this a problem? I get it, right? Karen, why are you here?
To love only.
She already said that.
You were supposed to say forgive everything.
So our vision statement at this center is...
Love only. Forgive everything. Remember who you are.
So what do you have to forgive? Who said, oh, God? God, maybe. So what do you have to forgive? Because I'm going to invite you today to forgive it. How's that feel? This is a tough crowd when it rains. But seriously, it's just about making a decision. So if there's anything in your heart that you need to forgive, forgive it. Let it go. In the famous words of Frozen, just let it go, let it go. That's all I know of that song. Let it go. Okay, so love only, forgive everything, remember who you are. And what is our mission statement? Do you all remember it? Do it now. So take a deep breath. So in advanced consciousness class, we're looking at Carl Sagan's daughter's book, Sasha Sagan, for small creatures such as we. And she's all about ritual. She wants us to reclaim, remember ritual. Like phones ringing, that's a ritual. Not a problem, Jeannie. Did you need to get that? Good. So ritual. And really what he means, what she means is for each one of us to start paying attention to the sacred in our lives. So just think about your life for a second. What would you constitute as sacred? What's sacred in your life? Your peace of heart, yeah. What's sacred in your life, Mindy?
My family.
Oh, yes. Kevin?
My husband.
And I reciprocate. So just find that thing in you that is sacred and let it fill your consciousness. So sacred, so secret, so precious, this love. So sacred, so secret, so precious, this love. Join us.
So sacred, so secret, so precious, this love.
Just let it fill you up.
So sacred, so secret, so precious, this love. I will share.
Yeah.
breath you take, and every exhale that comes from you, you are sharing this love. Because as Ernest Holmes says, love is the self-givingness of spirit to itself, meaning that there is something within you that is constantly giving you its life, its creativity, its inspiration, its knowingness, its wisdom. And it is you. It's who you are, what you are. So with every breath, be reminded that the sacred is found within you, because you are the sacred. So sacred,
so sacred,
so secret,
so precious,
so precious,
this love. So sacred,
so sacred,
so secret,
so secret,
so precious,
so precious,
this love I will share. Take a deep breath and let it go. Let's say thank you to these beautiful singers. It is something to keep reminding ourselves that we are the sacred, that we don't have to go outside of ourselves to find it. We actually need to drop into it in order to realize it, to feel it. And that's really been most of what my ministry has been about for these last 5-10 years, which is the experiential of this. You know, I can get up here and talk and speak and, you know, teach words, but if you're not experiencing it, if you're not feeling it, then what's the point? We are not just brains. We're also hearts, and we're souls, and we need to find that root from the brain to the heart and let the heart start thinking. I think the world would be a very different place if the heart was thinking more and the brain was thinking less, or together as one, let's say. So here to inspire us on this beautiful Sunday morning, welcome. Do I say doctor? I do, don't I? Julio Hernandez. Come up. You know it's not mandatory.
It is now.
Ooh, oh my goodness. Is that the price tag?
No.
What is that?
Okay.
Tell me about it.
So this is a,
I love the pictures.
A book that's basically takes a bunch of old Renaissance pictures, are different, and that are inspired. So they reimagined with men, you know,
wow.
And like Renaissance and different pictures, and so. Instead of women, they're men. So,
this is great.
Yeah, so.
Am I blushing?
Yes, I think you are
a little bit.
So, you know, instead of the woman with a pearl earring, it's like the man with the pearl earring. So, like a lot of these.
Wow, dark vintage.
Yeah, so.
People, things that inspire. I'm very inspired.
Yeah, so. Yeah, I think that so.
Oh, pearl earring.
Yeah.
That is, oh, I can show them that.
Yeah, that's a... So, inspiration, right?
Yeah. This gets me back to the gym. Anybody else? That is so beautiful. Thank you. Yeah. I love it.
Yeah, I figured you'd enjoy this.
I will.
You and Kevin.
Oh, my God, I love it. Absolutely. I'm going to put it right here for the day.
A nice coffee table book and stuff. So.
So I have to ask you, yes, obviously, what inspires you besides that?
For me, you know, music has always inspired me for a long time. As growing up, it's helped me get through a lot of tough times.
Yeah.
So a lot of artists and...
Who's your favorite?
Mark Almond.
Who?
Mark Almond.
Do you all know who that is? Who doesn't know who that is? Just so I don't feel... Good to know.
So he's a singer.
Like, what's one of his songs? Would I know one of his songs?
Yeah, he did the song Tainted Love. He read Tainted Love in the 80s. So with Soft Cell. He was with
Soft
Cell.
Before my time, but wow. That's really great.
So he's a big...
Anybody today inspire you in the music field?
Not necessarily in one specific, but, you know, different...
Genres. You know who inspires me musically? Adele. Anybody? She is just... I went to her concert, and I don't go to concerts. It's never been a thing that I've done much. And we went to her concert, and I think I complained the whole way there, just saying, ugh, sitting with all these people and this. And she was brilliant. It was like she was like your best friend who just happened to be on a stage singing. She was amazing and so down to earth. And then she'd just start singing, and it was like a laser beam right into my heart.
Yeah.
So I loved her. I love her.
You know who just came to mind when you said that?
And, who?
For me now was not necessarily singing, but just personality and who's doing a lot of stuff. It was Lil Nas X. And
Little who?
Lil Nas X.
Now watch this. Who doesn't know who that is? Oh, no, you do. Wow. Lil Nas, you know Caressa? No.
Okay. So
do
yeah.
You? Do you, Jed? Yes. Yeah, of course you do. You're in the music industry, yeah.
Okay. So, yeah. So.
What do I know a song of his or hers?
Old Town Road. He did that Old Town Road.
Old Town Road.
Yeah.
Now I got to go listen to him on the way home.
He did that one, but he's done a bunch of other stuff, more recent stuff.
But it's true. Music. But do you know why music inspires us? Do you know what it is about the music? We're only vibrations. We're only energy. But music, certain types, depending on what your energy is, those vibrations tap into you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, and people find this funny, but I actually love, is he rap?
Like rap, yeah.
I love rap music. My son, he's always playing me rap, and he always thinks I'm going to go like, and I'm like, I love that. His lyrics, the way they're using, even with all the F-bombs that are dropped and all the things that are said, I'm like, I totally get it. You too, Tiffany, you like rap. Yeah, because you rap a lot, don't you?
I do.
Yeah.
I have a teenage son.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
I have a teenage practitioner.
No, but what I like about him is that he's really pushing the boundaries on a lot of things and really really just out there about his sexuality and really just...
Is he gay?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, okay.
And just really out and...
Then I think I have heard him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Because I only follow the gay people.
No, so that's what great. I really, really enjoy about his personality and what he's doing. And
well, let me ask you something else. Yeah. What you just said. What is it? What does it mean to push the boundaries?
Means to be yourself. To be And also to expand what's the status quo is.
Do you push boundaries in your life?
I believe so. Sometimes, yeah. Sometimes in different aspects.
Yeah. How many of you are pushing the boundaries of your life? Good. You're not pushing the boundaries, Corinne? You don't think so? Would you like to?
Yes.
Okay. How many of you would like to push the boundaries of your life? Anybody? You don't want to, Mindy? Do you want to push the boundaries of it?
Sure.
I didn't feel investment from her, did you?
No.
Yeah. Carol, are you ready to push the boundaries?
I'm not ready to push the boundaries.
You're about to push some boundaries in a little bit, yeah. I love that idea of pushing boundaries. I feel like when I became a minister, that was one of my callings, to push the boundaries. And Steve Brabant can tell you, I was persona non gratis for a long time because of the way I approached this teaching and this philosophy, and people had a hard time with the way I was approaching it, the way I was pushing it past what 1927 Ernest Holmes was about. But now, I feel like a lot of it has caught up to me, and I need to keep going. Do you ever feel that?
Yeah, definitely.
Like your world is catching up to you, but now, okay, now what's next? What's this next thing? So what's next? I asked you in the hallway, what's next for you? Do you know?
Not necessarily. I've been working on my private practice, so with my MFT and my major family therapy.
Right.
So I've been doing that, and that's just expanding, doing that, and then eventually leaving from the education field and going into that. So
just being a private counselor, family counselor, and staying there.
Yeah, and I've gotten my certification in the somatic teaching. So
oh, that's wonderful.
So I'm doing more of that.
I learned so much more about you when you show up and tell everybody at the same time. Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, so I've been doing some of the somatic experiencing, and that's really cool. So that's really fun.
So our theme this month, back to inspire, what would you ask us to do to become more inspired?
Take a look around and do what you enjoy and live that and have fun. I think that's what it is.
That's
about
like,
joy, right? Joy.
That is the perfect answer. Take a look around and have fun. How many of you are doing that? How many of you could do more of that? Because that's what we're here to learn, right? So according to Dr. Julio Hernandez, take a look around and have fun. Right? Okay, Ray. Yeah, I'm good. We're good with that. Thank you. So do you want to give us do you want to give us the affirmation?
Of course. So the affirmation this week, this month is...
this week too.
Yeah. Is I allow spirit to inspire me from within. So I'll say it again together. Well, we'll say it together and then twice, right?
As many as you want.
All right, so 30 times.
Perfect, yes.
One for each day of the month. Oh, yeah. So I'll say it together.
I allow spirit to inspire me from within. Do you think they should stand for this?
Yeah, then let's stand up and shake it off. And
shake it out, that's it, yeah. Well, that's it, Caressa, perfect.
Yeah. And then
now, feel it. Remember last week I asked you all, how many people have been doing the breath every morning and every night before they go to bed? The rest of you totally forgot. I have not forgotten. Every morning I breathe. Did you watch last week?
No,
yeah, so yeah. So you breathe in from the belly, from the toes, all the way up through the belly. Take a deep breath in, hold it while you're allowing the inspiration to fill you, and then let it out very slowly. I've done it every morning and every night when I've gone to bed. So I'm going to invite you to do it now, maybe to remind you what you could start doing today. And breathe in. Hold. And just float there. And let it out. Now let's say it.
I allow spirit to inspire me from within.
How's that feel?
It's great.
Okay, Dr. Julio Hernandez. Thank you. I can't wait to look at that book. Okay. Are you ready?
Absolutely.
So, Carol informed me this morning. She sent me a bunch of songs to listen to, and I picked one, and I didn't really give much thought. I just picked the one that I knew and that I loved, and I knew I wanted to talk about. I said this morning, I said, how, I wasn't here for the rehearsal. I was like, how'd it go? She goes, good, good. And then Mindy said, you picked the hardest song to sing in the morning. I said, I just picked what she sent to me. And she said,
It was the hardest one of the ones I sent to you. Except for her, nothing's hard, because God sings through her. So here she is, Carol Hatchett. You ready?
So ready. So much. Thank you to the band.
Carol Hatchett.
Thank you.
Right?
Yeah.
So that's kind of the whole message, to be honest. It really is. The whole message is that the hero lies in you. But I wanted to just tell you a little story when I was a little boy. So when I was a little boy, one of my biggest, biggest heroes was Superman. Anybody else?
Yeah.
Right? Superman. Thank you, Ray. Right. And why? Because I loved the fact that he was Clark Kent. Because I saw myself as Clark Kent. Because I saw myself as this, and I was, this awkward, skinny, you know, extrovert with a big mouth who got into everybody's face, even though I was this skinny little kid. So I was bullied a lot. In fact, when I was putting this talk together, I thought about this one day, and it was my fault. I totally get that it was my fault, that I was really annoying this group of high schoolers, really annoying them, and I was like 7. And I was like running in and out of them, and I was trying to screw up their football game because I didn't want to play it. And so I'm like, and finally they picked me up and put me in a trash can. Literally, put me in a trash can, put the lid on, and then kicked it, and then said, "You don't come out of here till we tell you." I spent a long time in that trash can. And I was thinking about this. I was like, I almost didn't want to share it. I was like, do I really want people to think of me as somebody who was put inside of a trash can? Yes, I do. Because that's part of my history, part of who I am. And I thought about this in terms of Clark Kent. Think about all the people that used to make fun of Clark Kent or push him, just begging him to do something. But you knew what was inside of him. Well, I did too. So the title of my talk today is, first this quote. This is Christopher Reeves, obviously. There is a superhero in all of us, Jimmy. We just need the courage to put it on the cape. Well, of course he was talking to me. Because I am Jimmy. I was Jimmy. But I remember it wasn't Clark Kent who said it. It was someone else. I mean, it wasn't Christopher Reeves, but he's my favorite Superman. Anybody else? Is he your favorite Superman?
Yeah.
Henry Carville's nice, too. There was something inside of me I knew. I just knew. There was something bigger inside of me. So what a better inspiration than a guy who looks like this nerd who's very weak, who all he has to do is reach inside, pull open the shirt, and out comes a superhero, because there's a hero inside of all of us. So how do I translate that for me in my life? Well, I think for a long, 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 long time, you know, I grew up, I went to New York, I made a big deal out of myself in New York, and then even after that, there was still the skinny, awkward kid inside the Broadway star at the time, who was playing one of the most masculine characters ever written for a Broadway stage at that time. But inside, I was still Clark Kent, even though I appeared to have it all going for me. But I was Clark Kent. I didn't see me as most people saw me back then. I saw me still as that skinny kid who gets stuck into trash cans. Until I found Eric Butterworth. And I started that journey of trying to understand what's really inside of me. And it's not really the big S unless we call that spirit. That there is spirit inside of me. There is the truth inside of me. And as Clark Kent said, I have to be willing to put on the cape. So my question to you today is, are you, Diane, willing to put on the cape?
Absolutely.
Yes, I know you are. So the title of my talk today is The Caped Crusader. Now, here's what's funny. The Caped Crusader, do you know what the name of my high school football team's?
Crusade.
The Crusaders. We were the Crusaders. But I was caped. I was actually covered. I was the hidden crusader. And I want to thank Laurie Savage for finding this, because she sent me a bunch of images, but she found this one, and I was like, this is it. There's something inside of you here this morning that would you tap into it, you would find your infinite power, tapping into that power. So the Caped Crusader, I want to read you what Christopher Reeves wrote about playing Superman. He said, "What makes Superman a hero is not that he has power, but that he has the wisdom and the maturity to use the power wisely." From an acting point of view, that's how I approach the part. We all know Christopher Reeves' life story. You probably don't know that Christopher Reeves' birthday is the same as mine. Isn't that interesting? Talk about a hero. He was the quintessential hero in films. He was Superman, the Superman for my generation, certainly. But this part, what makes a Superman is not the power, because obviously he lost a lot of his human power as he got older. But his wisdom and maturity, his heroic way of living life, has inspired all of us in one way or another to see someone stay. And I was privileged enough to know Christopher and to know him before the accident and after the accident. And he has always been a huge inspiration to me. So the question I have so many questions for us this morning, but one of the questions is, what is it that keeps us covered up? What is it that keeps us living in personalities and in roles that don't allow us to shine forth? What is it in your life, what is it in my life that stops me from going forward? That stops me from really showing the world who I am? I often think to myself, if I ever really open up and let out what is in here to let out, oh my God, could you imagine more of me? But there is more of me, just like there is so much more of you than what you're willing to unleash. And that's really what today is all about. So this week in ministerial, all of the students were asked to do a video of a Ralph Waldo Emerson essay. And they had to do a video and then show it in class. All the students in class had to watch the video, take notes, and then write an essay on what they just saw. So that it was about, can you listen? Can you hear? Can you understand what's going on? But what was most important was, what's the one thing that this minister said that really got you? That really got you? Did that minister, to be minister, did that minister pull it all together and inspire you with one aspect, something that really captivates you? Well, Christy Bodkins Reeves did one, and hers was on character. And in the Emerson essay, he gave six qualities of character. And I had to laugh that the fifth, because you know my number is five, the fifth character, the fifth characteristic of character, the fifth quality of character was connection to the divine. Connection to the divine. You know what that means? What Emerson said all those years ago? That one of your greatest qualities is your ability to know that you are God, to know who you are, to remember who you are. Underneath all of this, remember who you are. Underneath all of this, are you willing to remember that there's a hero inside of you just waiting to get out if you have the guts to put on the cape? So Emerson said this in that essay, "Man's true character is the capacity to surrender to the universe moving through him." Well, I just want that to settle into you for a minute. And I don't know why this is making me so emotional. Because there's a whole universe moving through me right now. And if I get out of the way and let that happen, that's inspiration. That's when I'm inspired. When I'm inspired to think and create and write and dance and sing and all the things that I love to do. Ever since I put it out there that I want more creativity in my life, it's funny. A couple weeks ago, I was invited. An actor called me, wrote me an email, and said, "Would you consider doing a reading of a new musical?" I haven't been asked to act in a very long time, and Kevin even laughed. He went, "Why'd they ask you?" I was like, "Because this person remembered me from back when," and so I said yes, and I did it yesterday, and I showed up, and there's 20 actors all sitting in a room, and it was very interesting because when I got the script, I had been asked to really read the starring role. And so I got this little bit of oh, I remember what this was like. I remember how I had to actually be good at it. And I opened the show with a monologue. And I went in and there was a room full of Broadway actors that I knew. And it was really a great experience because man's two characters, the capacity to surrender to the universe moving through him. You know what the universe moving through you isn't? Afraid.
Yes.
Right? You know what else the universe moving through you isn't? Judgmental. It's not criticizing you. It's not a critic. It's not seeing if you're as good as the other universe moving through the people. It just isn't. It doesn't care about any of that. And so I just took a deep breath and started. And it was a new musical version of A Midsummer Night's Dream. So I started, and I started with my monologue, and in my ear I heard myself going, "Wow, you are like chewing the scenery here." And I thought, but that's what the script's like, so I just chewed the scenery. I had the most wonderful time letting the universe move through me. It was so invigorating. And when we finished act one and we took the break, the guy who wrote the play came up to me and he says, "Oh my God, you are perfect for this." He said, I just love what you're doing. You're just perfect for this. He said, "Would you consider this if we do a production?" And I went, "Remember when it started out and it said, Theseus, 40, handsome, muscular?" He went, "Yeah." I said, "I'm 70. Handsome and muscular." So we either fix the first page So this whole idea today of allowing yourself to find that thing inside of you, Julio said it perfectly. What is inspiration? Looking around and having fun. Finding what inspires you, what is the spirit in you, that big giant S on your chest, and then letting it out. Right, Judd? You did that on Friday night. Judd sat up here on Friday night, right about here, for those of you that were here. I don't know how you do what you do. He has these instruments and blows into things and computers go. And the music was otherworldly. It was great. Scott's over here playing all of his instruments, and I'm playing the bowls, and Swan is in the back doing all this crazy techno stuff. And talk about inspiration. There was one point I was sitting there, I stopped playing the bowls, and I just went, "Just listen to the universe flowing through all of us." It was just fabulous. I mean, that's what we're here to do. And if you haven't been to one of our soul immersions, please join us. We're always packed, but I'm happy to move more seats out of the way to give more people opportunities to experience that. So, surrendering to the universe. So Emerson said this, and I love this. "A hero is no braver than an ordinary man, but he is brave 5 minutes longer." Isn't that good? So here's my question. How long each day do you remember who you are? How often are you clear? Do you remember who you are? How much of the time you spend breathing and being awake and conscious, are you breathing from that place of knowing who you are? I mean, it's what we teach. Remember who you are. And when I saw this quote, one of the reasons why I wanted to use it is because we just need to do it 5 minutes more. Every day. Just 5 minutes more. What would your life be like if every day, for 5 minutes more than you normally do, you remembered that you are the power of the universe, Tiffany? I know you do it 24/7, but most of us don't. Just think about that. If just 5 minutes, 5 minutes more living in that consciousness, that remembrance of who you are. Here's another question. Do you pull that cape out when you need it? When something happens to you in your life? You know, are you like those, like I was when I was a Catholic boy? I always, always was talking to Jesus when I needed help. Anybody else?
Yeah,
when you need it. What I find funny is very often religious scientists, when they need it, they disappear because it seems like, wait, I should be able to handle this. So they go away. And you know, when anybody tries to do that in my life, I get right on them. I'm like, no, 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 no. This isn't when you go away. This is when you lean in. This is when you take 5 more minutes and remember who you are. And then 5 more minutes after that. So, are you one of those people that only pull out the cape when you need it? And my second question is, and this is the big one, or are you one of those people who are just waiting for Superman to save you? Do you have the Lois Lane problem? How many Lois Lanes are out here? Huh? Yeah, right? We want someone. Yes, right. Liza, you are not Lois Lane. Right? So we do. We tend to think something, because we were brought up this way. Most of us were brought up Christian, I would think, or Jewish, and we were told that God is going to save us. Jesus is going to save me. I can't tell you how long I talked to Jesus from inside that trash can. And Jesus did nothing. Absolutely nothing except keep me company. That was you going to say that? Yeah, that's all Jesus did that day. So, today's lesson, that one thing I was telling you that I tell the ministers they have to do, the only thing that is ever going to save you in any situation, no matter what, is right on that board to remember who you are. Because if you remember who you are, nothing and no one and no thing, no experience can derail you. That's the absolute truth. So, my last slide. I had to give Henry Carvel at least one slide, right?
Cavill?
James Carvel, Henry Cavill.
This is James Carville's son, Henry Cavill. Yes. So, this is a job for Superman. Now, I have Superman on the board there saying, this is a job for Superman, but that's not really how that line is usually used. It's used by people saying, this is a job for Superman, we need to call him. Right. We need to call out to something outside of ourselves to help us. But what I'm saying is, it's time for us to get on board with this quote. This is a job for Superman. Living, you know what? Carol coming up onto this stage and singing that song at 10:30 in the morning, that was a job for Superman. Yeah. Right, Carol? And I watched her face when she came up the steps, and I watched her make a decision. I am just going to sing this sucker, and we'll see what happens. Right? Is that what you were thinking?
Always.
Always, right? Yeah. Yeah. And I kind of felt that way yesterday. I was like, I'm just going to overact and really throw it out there and see what happens. I didn't have to sing any high notes, though, which was good. So this is a job for Superman. Are you willing to start really remembering what's inside of you? We're talking about inspiration this month. The only way to become inspired is to be the inspiration, to know that that's what's inside of you. So, this little sentence, this is a job for Superman, I'm going to invite you to use it for the rest of this month, for as long as you like. Every time something comes up that feels to you like, this is bigger, this is too big, this is too much. How many of you have ever had a moment where you're like, this is just way too much for me? Yeah, we all have. Well, that's when you can say, Sonny, this is a job for Superman.
Superwoman.
And so forth. Yes. For a super person. Super them. Yes. John Livesey. Do you all remember John Livesey? He's been in Austin now for like 4 years, I think it's been. He teaches corporate. He goes to corporations and teaches corporate leadership. And he has his own cape. He literally bought a cape. And in his, he makes everybody get, I'm not going to do it. Maybe I will. He makes everybody get up and take the Superman pose. And in his, he actually makes, you see all these corporate people. You did it, didn't you do it once with him? No, and you never would you? Tiffany, come up here for a minute. Really, come up here for 1 second. Give her some encouragement, folks. What did you say?
You're the worst.
I thought you said we're divorced. I was like, okay. So what John does is he makes people just do this and stand. Now just stand there. How's it feel?
Chesty.
Me too. But just feel it. Doesn't it feel, is there a power to that?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah. Yes.
Now eye gaze.
No, I can't eye gaze with her. I can do that, yes. But John talks about this. So this is a job. Now we're just going to say, this is a job for Superman. And really, give me some like big, you know, Superwoman thing. Ready?
Okay.
This no, I'm doing it with you. Oh, you want to do it by yourself once? Go ahead.
Yes.
Wait, you're behind my thing here. We want them all to see this.
Center stage. This is a job for Superman.
And then you went like that.
This is a job. This is a job for Superman.
That was really good. Now don't put your hands on your hips till the word Superwoman.
This is a job for Superwoman.
Okay, you all have to do it. Everybody stand. It's good. Okay. Julio, come up and do it with us. Your inspiration for the day. Wait, you should do it once by yourself. Ready?
Okay.
Get chesty.
Chest.
Not until the end. Go ahead.
This is a job for Superman.
Wow, see, that looks good. Doesn't that feel good?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. You ready, everybody? This is a job for Superman. Hold it. Okay, who didn't do it? One more time. Didn't that feel good? Didn't it, Virginia? Yeah. Virginia's like, sure. Can I sit down now? Okay, one more time, one last time. And this is a job for Superman. And scene. Thank you, you too. I appreciate it. So, what do you think you're going to leave here today remembering?
Superman.
Yes, you're going to remember that there is something inside of you, Lisa, that is bigger than anything that could possibly be existing outside of you. Do you remember that?
Yes.
Absolutely. Superman. You, Stan?
Oh, yes.
That was good, yeah. So there is something inside of you that is bigger than any aspect of life that could ever show up. And you are one of the people that prove that every day, Virginia.
Yes.
Really, you know that. Right, Cal?
Right.
Yes. So, I want you to go back and think about your younger self, your youngest self, just your 7-year-old self. There it is, right here. And here you are today. I guarantee you, that 7-year-old self is inspired by this person. Know that. Remember that. Remember that right where you are, no matter what is going on, there is a hero that lies within you. And all you have to do is be willing to open it up, put on the cape, and stand in your truth by remembering who you are. Namaste. Okay. Okay, take a deep breath. I invite you to take out your contribution this morning. Thank you for that. That was so great. Recognize and know that right where you are, everything is flowing through you, as Emerson said. Robbie, give me some pretty music here. Julio, could you just give us a little treatment here? As you hold in your hand what you're giving today, your investment, your tithe, whatever you want to call it.
So this is what I know. I know that there's only one thing only, that is energy and love. Mm-hmm. This energy, this love that moves through us just circulates. As it circulates, this energy just flows. And I give thanks for it. I give thanks for this energy, this tithe. It just moves. And as I give thanks, I release it. I release it as together we say.
And so it is. Thank you. I've got a roof over my head. I've got a warm place to sleep. Some nights I lie awake counting gifts instead of counting sheep. I've got a heart that can hold love. I've got a mind that can think. There may be times when I lose the light and let my spirit sink, but I can't stay depressed when I remember how I'm blessed. Grateful, grateful, truly grateful. Something to mind that you're grateful for. Someone, something.
Within a city of strangers.
What do we have?
I have a family of friends. No matter what rocks or brambles fill the way, I know my friends will stay. Till the end, there is a power inside you. It's not a thing you can see.
It's that cape.
But on the road to this journey's end, this love will set me delight and despair, always bright and always there.
Everybody.
Grateful, grateful, truly grateful I am. Grateful, grateful, truly.
Good morning. It's Sunday, April 14th, and here are your GTC announcements. Coming up on the calendar, this coming Friday at 7 p.m., join Dr. Eric Overholzer for his next 9D breathwork experience with the theme of abundance. Yeah. There are limited tickets available for this event, so we recommend you purchase yours now. You can find the event on our website on the calendar page. Next Sunday, the Wisdom Women have their monthly meeting after service. Learn how to use the creative process to explore self-expression and gain personal insight in this special presentation. This event takes place in person only, so be sure to attend next Sunday. We have a number of Divine Dining and Doing events available now. On Saturday, April 27th, we have our 24 Hours of Madness performance with an entire evening of plays that are written, rehearsed, and performed in just 24 hours. It's madness. The next day, join Dr. James and Kevin for a bowling party on Sunday, April 28th. We have just 16 spots, so if you don't want to strike out, spare a few moments today to buy your tickets. Then on Saturday, May 11th, Carolyn Clemens is hosting a dinner party and house concert. It's gourmet dining and a special musical performance by Craig Lincoln. For these and the other events we have coming up, you can see Jill or Marilyn after service today or buy your tickets online. You can always find out what's going on by visiting our calendar on the website. To find it easily, just use your cell phone on the QR codes you see throughout the sanctuary. Have a fantastic week, everyone.
Thank you, Thor. So I want to talk for 1 second about bowling. So I think there are now like 3 slots left, maybe 3 or 4 slots left. It's $75 a person. That is for the bowling, the shoes, and drinks, and appetizers. So we've gotten a great deal there. And we're also only putting 4 people on a lane so that we could really bowl, because they originally do 6, but we opted to put 4 people on a lane. So please join us for this bowling extravaganza. Also, 24 Hours of Madness, which happens the night before, you see that it's $25 to attend or $50 for a weekend pass. $50 for the pass means you get to come on Friday night when the whole thing is put together, because what it will be is a group of actors, writers, and directors. The writer gets up and picks 2 themes that they have to write about, picks a director, then a director comes up, picks how many actors they get, and then picks those actors. And then in 24 hours, an entire play is written, directed, memorized, learned. Well, memorized is kind of humorous, but paraphrased and produced with slides and sound cues. I mean, it's just amazing. So if you get the weekend pass, you get to come Friday night, watch that happen, and you can come in any time throughout the day on Saturday and watch the madness of everybody trying to put their pieces together. So that's those two events. Was there something else, Kevin?
I don't think so.
No. Okay. So everybody, yes. Oh, come on up. Yeah. Here.
So I hope you'll consider joining one of the 9D breathworks if you haven't done it. It's a pre-recorded audio sound experience, which focuses in on your breath. And I just want to share, I got a testimonial recently from one of our congregants, I won't mention her name, who I did a one-on-one session on this journey on abundance. And within about 3 weeks, she had a new apartment, a new car, and had tripled her monthly income. And she's now a member of the union. So in terms of, it's really an opportunity to dive in for her to really look at some of her true deep beliefs of abundance and break through them. And for abundance, compared to bowling, this is a bargain. I don't know what we're charging. This is one of those opportunities. I think.
But you're going bowling.
Maybe. We'll see how the abundance journey works for me. But for $35, that is, I think, what they're charging now. It's an hour and a half opportunity that you can really dive in deep. There are many people that have had an experience saying that they've had more emotional release and transformation in one session than 4 years of therapy. So hope you'll consider it.
Great, good. Okay, hit it.
Lexi, our soul child today. There you go.
Thank you.
That's beautiful.
So this month in youth ministry, we're working on meditation. And I'm not sure if you're all aware of this. Sometimes when we sit down to meditate, when we're under a certain age, we do a lot of fidget. We do a lot of, I don't know what the heck I'm doing. So we're exploring different ways to meditate, because really all we're trying to do is clear our minds out, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So today we worked with color. We did some painting, only we did it
blindfolded.
Oh, we did it blindfolded. This was Lexi's very first painting we did.
Wow, that's great. That was blindfolded,
this
Lex?
This is blindfolded. Now, one of the things, we talked about this ahead of time, so I'm just going to tell you a few things, and then we're going to hear from Lex. One of the things we discovered was when we paint, we did the blindfold meditation, then we took the blindfold off to see what was there. Maybe we corrected a few edges. Maybe we added a little things to it. We took what was there and worked from that space, which is what we do when we meditate, right? Yeah. We sit down and we get our minds clear. We let something come up for us, and then we take what we get from that and we move forward with it. We add to it, we detract from it, we change it, we alter it, we make it our own. So this was the first pass that Lexi did. Now show them your second pass.
That was blindfolded?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
So Lexi wanted to explain to you her take on meditation. So brace yourselves.
Great.
Hold it up to your mouth so they can hear you say it. Do you want to hold?
Yeah.
Okay.
I forgot what I was going to say.
Oh, you forgot? That's good for me. I mean, you were going to say why meditation?
Meditation is hard, so... And I like to fidget around a lot, so this was a lot easier to, like, meditate. And we meditate because sometimes we need a break from the world because life is hard and some people are jerks sometimes.
Yeah, got it. Yeah. Good.
And this was our lesson for the day.
Did you do all of these blindfolded? Like, how did you know which color to pick? You memorize the palette.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow. That was the other part we came up with, was when we sit down to meditate, right, don't we make the room the way we want it? Don't we set the lights and we set our music and maybe we have a quote that we want to focus on? We set the space for ourselves. So what Lexi did was she made sure the paints were where she needed them and the water and everything was where she could find it with her hands. And that way her meditation was set perfectly for her.
That's beautiful. It's like the LGBTQ rainbow flag.
Kinda. Yeah. It's all the colors of the
beautiful
rainbow.
Beautiful. Okay, let's give it up for these guys. Thanks, Connie. Okay, everybody. Come on. Consciousness on Demand today. Caressa McElhaney, where will you be?
Upstairs.
So Caressa will be up here in the meditation room. Stan will be downstairs. If you're like having trouble letting Superman or Superwoman out, go sit with these guys. They will have their capes on. They will stand right on top of you like this and know the truth, yes? So join them in the meditation room downstairs. Excellent. Okay, I invite you all to stand up. I want to say another thank you, because she's going away for a few weeks, to Carol.
Thank you. Thank you all for being just so wonderful to me all the time. This is a beautiful place to land every week for me. All your beautiful faces, all your lovely hugs. Thank you very much. Love you. Thanks, guys.
So take a deep breath and know that right here in this moment, there is a hero within each of our hearts. And that hero is taking even more time to realize the power that we are, the wisdom that we have, the ability we have to see through the eyes, as the eyes of God, whatever that means to you. And I am so grateful for everyone's participation today. Thank you, everybody online, for joining us, for being a part of this beautiful spiritual community.
I recognize and know that there is that place that when you are in your place and I'm in my place, we are in that one place. It's called love. So I just recognize this and I let it be so. As we all say together, and so it is. Okay, here we go. So you think there's nothing new under the sun? If it's possible, it's already been done. If you think this stage has all been set, well, think again. You ain't seen nothing yet. The sun will come up with a wave of your hand. You'll smack